Hello. High-speed connectivity is critical to business development, especially in Asia-Pacific, because of the distances involved. But just laying fibre from A to B is only part of the solution. You need high-powered software and hardware at either end as well. Here's Infinera's Mark Showalter to explain.
When you look at high-speed optical networks, there's a couple of key technologies that really differentiates Infinera in this space. The first is the ability to create a long-haul optical superchannel. Infinera is the only provider on the market that can deliver a 500 gig long-haul superchannel. How do we do that? Our photonic integrated circuits. Nobody else on the market today is delivering a large-scale photonic integrated circuit. Photonic integrated circuits take a lot of individual components and put them onto one package. That one package becomes very reliable. It uses less heat, less power, less space. So starting with this chip, the photonic integrated circuit, it lets you build a super channel, very high speed, high capacity, and then it lets you turn it on really quickly. So the business benefit of the technology is being able to grow your network very fast to very high speeds. We can, for example, put 9 terabits of traffic onto one fiber, which is, you know, if you look at back in 2005, the entire internet did not have 9 terabits of capacity. But today we can put 9 terabits of capacity onto one fiber. So the photonic integrated circuit is a key capability for that.
So what do Infinera's customers, the carriers, say?
Well, I think Infinera's role in the long-haul fiber is basically going to be about helping to optimize, create greater efficiency, and hopefully help us introduce greater standards in terms of how we can use it moving forward.
Infinera is our core optical network solution for long-haul. They've done an extraordinary job. What we're looking forward to is a metro form factor solution. So we would like to see all of their SDN capability that we're working with today that gives us flexible software-defined optical networks where I can make vertically sliced multi-layer networks all on top of Infinera. We're looking forward to that happening and surfing their roadmap into the future.
Data center networks are moving to SDN. So what's Infinera's view of a software-defined wide area network?
When I think about the benefits of a software-defined WAN, I first start by looking about the benefits of SDN in the data center. If you really look at what SDN has enabled in the data center, it's enabled virtualization and it's enabled fast creation of services so that service providers can be more agile in what they're rolling out. As SDN expands outside the data center to the WAN, we're really looking at a number of applications that are driving SDN. The first application we're seeing most likely is data center interconnect, essentially using SDN to expand your control outside of the data center to between data centers to be able to create efficiencies across the wider network. So if you need to synchronize data centers around the world, or if you need to deal with a disaster recovery situation and send traffic from here to there, SDN offers a way to more efficiently manage your network.
And what's the industry analyst's view?
Look, SDN in the WAN addresses some issues around traffic prioritization and applications performance, which has continued to plague the WAN. So I think SDN is absolutely fundamental to addressing that going forward. If you look at some of the demand placed upon it, say with BYOD and also to a certain extent cloud, I would look at that as a precursor to where demand is going to grow. Now, if you look at those country markets, you have Australia, absolutely, heavy BYOD in both cloud adoption there. China is another area where BYOD is absolutely making its presence felt, or at least the mobile is in the business context. India, absolutely, New Zealand, Singapore, all those country markets are going to be good adopters of SDN technology.
Every time I'm asked a question about Asia, I highlight to people the fact that it's not one region. It's a multiplicity of countries and regulations that are at very different developmental levels. Cloud is a huge opportunity for everybody across that spectrum, from the mature markets of Australia, Hong Kong, Singapore, those sorts of guys who have extensive on-premise environments. For them, SDN and similar cloud technologies are going to be a way of managing their costs, of improving their utilization, and making the migration step from on-premise to cloud.
I think when you look at it, it's naturally going to apply to those that are higher in the maturity index. Those countries that have already evolved into a space where they're ready for the capabilities of what SDN can bring will be first mover. Equally, you'll find the verticals, you know, such as the banking industry, which are somewhat curious around what technology can bring, they'll move into that space. I think really when you prioritise across what opportunities customers and countries have right now, I'm not necessarily sure that this is sitting in the top five. I think the top five really is trying to come to grips with, one, the opportunity costs of owning infrastructure, two, understanding, you know, how it is that they can be more customer centric and therefore information led around a lot of their strategies, and then three, how is it that they create a more agile workforce that allows them to compete in the new landscape.
And what do the carriers say?
One of the things that we've found operating in Asia Pac as an operator is that there is a unique situation compared to all other regions in the world, in fact in Asia. When we have customers that have global data center requirements, they are tending to build things where they have two data centers in Europe, two data centers in America, and two data centers in Asia. What has happened though is that those two data centers are very close to each other in Europe, they're very close to each other in the US, and typically in Asia, they're in Hong Kong and Singapore, or Tokyo and Hong Kong, or Sydney and Hong Kong. In other words, they're quite widely separated. And this has a very wide-ranging impact on how people design their network and their data center environments, which then has a knock-on effect across the entire globe. So the Asia-Pac region is actually a very interesting problem from a networking perspective. How do I deliver high-performance networking over quite large distances and support cloud and all the other things that I need to support into data center operability? And SDN, of course, is a very important component of that. SDN exists within the data center itself, and then it exists within the WAN environment also. Those two domains might not talk directly to each other today. So the SDN within the data center environment may well be the enterprise's SDN, and the SDN that sits within the carrier environment is the carrier's. And today there isn't a defined set of standards of how those two might talk to each other. But the fact that that SDN can exist within the WAN environment, it can provide adaptability, it can provide a better utilization of assets between these data centers that tend to be quite a long way apart, that's very, very valuable to operators. And it's something that, as I said, gets a particular focus in the Asia Pacific region because of these distances that we're having to cover. It's not so important to manage large amounts of capacity between two sites that are quite close together, but if you're carrying capacity internationally, it becomes absolutely critical to do so. So I think really the Asia-Pac region has got a head start at looking at some of these problems.
So what has been the response in Asia-Pacific to Infinera's technology?
The thing that really stands out is, of course, their roadmap to extremely dense bandwidth. Their picks are very exciting, and in particular, Infinera really understands optical SDN. They have a real solution today. It doesn't throw away GMPLS. We feel the capabilities of GMPLS do create a flexible, malleable, and dynamic optical network that doesn't compromise restoration, resiliency, and survivability. So building SDN on top of their GMPLS solution is definitely the right way to go. And they even give options for lightening up the use of GMPLS in the solution and leaning heavier on explicit SDN-defined provisioning.
The response in Asia-Pacific to our technology has been very strong. If you look at the number of deployments we've seen across Asia-Pacific, we've seen Telstra Global deploy our new DTNX platform, we've seen PACnet deploy the platform, we've seen Daycom Crossing, the list goes on. If you look at what's happening in Asia Pacific, we're seeing strong growth in the demand for bandwidth. And if you combine the network topologies, there's a lot of subsea links across Asia. And that is a natural fit for our product. So the excitement is there because we're able to deliver high-speed, high-capacity super channels today, and very long distance that can do terrestrial as well as subsea networks. So across Asia Pacific, as service providers are becoming cloud operators, they're looking at 100 gig, and they're looking at Infinera as the way to deliver that.